Well, the Department of Justice now has a number of problems with the deal. First of all, higher airfares. They say, for example, American Airlines and US Airways, the US Airways Advantage, cheaper fares would be restricted. There would be less competition through non-stop city pairs. Then they say there'd be higher fees for baggage, flight changes and the like, and there would see reduced choice for services. Charlie Leosha is the director of the Consumer Travel Alliance, who testified against the merger before the US Congress. Charlie, even you must admit, this was a surprise that they didn't just go for some form of divestiture or some sort of recompense. They're going to block it. You must have been surprised too.
Well, I will say that I'm surprised that it happened today, and I'm very, very pleased. Only yesterday I was talking with people and I basically gave it a 50-50 chance. I've been doing an awful lot of work with the Department of Justice. I've spoken with them several times. And I know that the lawyers there at the Department of Justice really are probably the best team that consumers could possibly have had looking at this merger. And when it started off, I thought it was a 90-10 slam dunk. But then as things went along and our organization, the Consumer Travel Alliance, came out with an overlapping competing route study. All of a sudden, we saw that one-stop routes, there were 761 of those, which were where we had American and United, or American and US Air, competing with each other.
The problem, of course, is, well, but the problem is, in this regard, American, of course, now is more competitive because it's got its cost base down. US Airways has been trying to look for or has been thought to need a partner. If this deal does not go through, I understand you're the consumer's voice. I understand that. But put that to one side for one second. If this deal does not go through, these two smaller airlines are at a disadvantage compared to the colossus of United and the behemoth of Delta.
Well, you might say that. But then again, you might say that they have an advantage. They're going to be able to focus on their own markets. They'll be able to provide better service. They'll be able to give consumers what they really want. Let's look at what happened with Southwest Airlines. It started as a tiny little airline in Texas, and now it flies more passengers domestically than any other airline, including the behemoths. So if someone pays attention to their consumers, if they treat them with dignity, if they maintain control over their pricing, consumers will fly on that airline.
The evidence,
I don't see that problem.
The evidence on the US Airways, I mean, I've read the studies up to a certain point, not as much as yourself. And if you look at the non-stops and the competing non-stops, there's not that many of them. And I accept your point about the one-stops and the baggage fees and all of those. But is it the right way for the DOJ to basically say a deal that everybody signed off on with an airline that is bankrupt, that is just days from closing a transaction, should now be stopped? It's late in the day.
No, I don't think that it's wrong. What's wrong is that the airlines have given the impression that this was moving along and it was not going to be objected to. They knew that this was a dicey situation with the Department of Justice. They knew ahead of time that this was going to be a close call. But they've gone along and they made a PR decision that they were going to act as though nothing was happening. In the meantime, we've been working very, very diligently since Valentine's Day when they announced their little love affair. And we have worked in Congress. Right. We've worked with a lot of people to make sure that they understand where consumers stand. And that's the difference here. What you're talking about is bankruptcy, and bankruptcy deals with creditors and with stockholders. But when you're talking antitrust, that deals with consumers. And that's the big difference.
Last question here. Now, again, I know you want this deal out the window, dead and buried under 6 foot of soil, but is it your experience judgment in this that really what we're going to see here is a negotiating position with the DOJ and that eventually a deal will be done? It may be more divestiture, it may be more oversight or whatever, but the deal will eventually take place?
I don't think it's going to happen. I think that this deal is dead. We have an enormous loss of competition across the country. The General Accountability Office marked something like 1,665 airport pairs, which lose competition. And it is a nationwide problem. It's not a problem that can be solved by just giving up a couple of slots.